gentlemen, French Bread.
Living happily. Have you ever seen a young girl's bouncy hair bouncing all around? She doesn't have a care. To a sea of curiosity. to welcome everybody here tonight. Celebrate the Grateful Dead celebration. Hope everybody's having a good time, enjoying their food and drinks. A lot of good bands coming up. It's our pleasure to start off the night for you. The world is much bigger to me than the stars. All the clouds in the sky, the world, it's much bigger to me than my mind. Everything all right. Let me was standing on the corner crying, losing your love.
That's French Bread. Till Dead. My name is Sean O'Neill. I'm your MC tonight, the Vice President of AMFM.
Hey, I'm PJ Thomas, Secretary.
First of all, I gotta say, you're our biggest crowd yet. So thank you for coming out. Great job, Annapolis. So BJ, tell them about AMFM.
Okay, so we are the Annapolis Musicians Fund for musicians. We raise money for musicians. Our local musicians, whether they get ill, lose a gig for whatever reason, we step in and we help them out. And by you being here, you're helping us, helping them out too. So thank you. Thank you so much.
So tonight, as you know, we're going to be playing some Grateful Dead songs, like you heard, and then also some songs written by our local artists that are in the style of the Grateful Dead. So in the vein of, the direction of, it's not vein as in V-E-I-N.
It's V-A-N-E, like a weather vane.
Weather vane. It's a pun. We know it's spelled wrong.
We know it's spelled wrong, yes. We did it on purpose.
So, I saw this quote from Jerry Garcia. This was from an interview in 1972. He said, "The Grateful Dead is not for cranking out rock and roll. It's not for going out and doing concerts or any of that stuff. I think it's to get high. I'm not talking about unconscious or zonked out. I'm talking about being fully conscious." He said that in 1972, and there's a lot of themes in their music. We'll go through that as in between acts. We'll keep you guys entertained so that you can learn a little bit about that. But I'm hoping our next act is set up here. They're getting there? Okay.
Hey, is there anybody here that this is their first In the Vein Of show? Your first? Okay. How many people have been to, who was at the Fleetwood Mac show? Okay. Awesome. Oh, the Beatles. Who was at the Beatles show? Okay. How about Led Zeppelin? Here's one for you. Our tribute to David Bowie. Okay.
And you know what, PJ, we did something unusual this year. What we did is we sold subscriptions. And we had about 100 people buy subscription tickets to all three In the Vein Of shows this year. So thank you guys for doing that.
Oh, you know what? I just thought of something. So in the back of the room, we've got Jenny Brady from Naptownmusic. She's recording the show. So, you know, while the musicians are playing, if you can kind of keep the talking down, she will be able to record the show and it'll be available for you to go back and look, you know, for the rest of your life. So thank you, Jenny, back there. I think I see you. There she is. We also want to thank our sound people. We've got Adam and we've got Ethan. They're always the absolute best. So give a big hand to them.
So I first saw this band a number of years ago in a different phase. They were called Willie's Light at that time, but now they've changed the name. So tonight, Paul Williams Band.
How's everybody feeling? All right, so I first saw the Grateful Dead in 1980 with a church group. I then saw them again in 85, started the touring, and saw countless shows. So they're a big influence in my life, and this is what we got for you.
Doesn't matter.
sail the seas. Walk with that is set me free. In this big old world I don't even know. Gonna pack my bag, it's time for me to go. We'll be right back. Thank you very much.
For this show, don't you think? Good job. So in 1953, a guy by the name of Lawrence Ferlinghetti opened a bookstore called City Lights Bookstore in the North Beach District of San Francisco. North Beach represent. This became a gathering place for a lot of American writers, most notably Jack Kerouac and Allen Ginsberg. They moved to San Francisco in the mid-50s, and in 1957, Jack Kerouac put out this book, On the Road. Anybody read it? I would hope so. If you're a Dead fan, you should have read this book. This book is woven in between a lot of their songs. It's heavily influenced. In fact, one of the main characters in the book, Dean, if you guys have read the book, Dean actually is Neil Cassidy in real life. And he hung out with the Dead quite a bit. He was part of their entourage and eventually, unfortunately, passed away. And they wrote a song about him, Cassidy, as you probably know. You'll probably hear that later tonight. So as you continue to hear a lot of the themes through tonight, you'll hear a lot to do with traveling and being on the road, which kind of goes with the whole Deadhead theme and them always touring and being a part of their fabric. So, you guys ready?
I think we're ready.
All right. Next up, we have Unified Jazz Ensemble.
Thanks a lot, Sean. So, we've got our secret weapon, Nate Stanley, here with us tonight. He was on the last in the Vane show when we did the Beatles, so thanks for coming out and supporting the cause. Thanks for supporting Annapolis Musicians. We'd like to dedicate our performance to someone who knows a lot about the Grateful Dead. She's actually the reason we're here. She knows a lot about scheduling, too. I heard a big a lecture from her the other night on scheduling. She knows a lot about scheduling, so if you want to talk to her about that, you can. Her name is Mary. So here we go. This is our first show. We're going to do an original we did, and then we'll do Bert.
If you please, bring you to your knees. Don't go.
that same sweet song again. Will you know why? Anyone who sings a tune so sweet is passing by. You
Yes! Gotta have jazz in a dead show, right? The improv. Gotta have the improv. So does anybody here have Harry Smith's Anthology of American Folk Music? Anybody? It's not exactly a bestseller, but it's a 6-album collection. It's got Appalachian folk, fiddle, gospel, hillbilly, blues, Cajun music. If you can actually find the original record, there's a 28-page book. It's got liner notes in it to tell you all about each of the songs. It's got a great, some pictures in there, as well as the pictures of the people that are playing it on the album, as well as some art. And it was central to the Grateful Dead's early years. They started out as a jug band. So as a jug band, they played this folk music, this bluegrass. And what I found interesting is that Harry Smith actually composed this book and this album while he was at the Chelsea Hotel. And it always seems like so much of American music, modern music, is tied to the Chelsea Hotel in New York City. But I thought that was appropriate before these guys came up. Because Rob, the guy that actually wrote the book, Harry Smith, he went on to win a Lifetime Achievement Award from the Grammys. And then he also went on to be supported by the Grateful Dead. They used to give him $10,000 a year. You guys ready? Yeah? All right, so that he could live. All right, next up we have Moose Jaw Bluegrass. Thank you. today. The wind's gonna rise and blow my blues away. And if you like what you hear, come to Mother's Peninsula Grill in Arnold this Friday and hear us play more. So we're going to play an original now. This is called Eric and the Bear, inspired by a semi-true event that took place in Greenbelt, Maryland. Thank you.
Once again, we are Moose Jaw. Thank y'all so much. This is officially a Hoop Mandy now. Thanks. I've only learned a couple of cover songs in my life, probably like 20. That's me, I know. It's awesome. You love that clicking, clacking? That's what happens, Adam. This is what happens, am I right? It's Spinal Shack. Every show. I think it's a pedal. Anyway. So yeah, this is one of the first covers I ever learned. But then this week I found out that who's a fan of our current president? No one? It's fucking awesome. Well, nobody voted for our current president because his name is Steve Bannon. But I found out that Steve Bannon was fucking dead. No shit, that's fucked up. He obviously ate the brown acid. So. That's his excuse, I guess. But he was. And I'm just wondering, did I like smoke a joint with this fucking gin blossom pock face asshole? But anyway, back to the spirit of love and kindness. So it is a good segue. Right? So the main song isn't about it, but in the middle, I figured I'd do a little tribute to the Grateful Dead, going in and out of another song, and that's for him. Whew. Anyway.
Shoes. The women in Deep Ellum got them Deep Ellum blues. Oh, sweet mama, your daddy's got them Deep Ellum blues. Oh, sweet mama, your daddy's got them Deep Ellum blues. I one time knew a preacher preached a Bible. Went down to Deep Ellum and his preaching days were through. Oh, sweet mama, your daddy's got them Deep Ellum blues. Oh, sweet mama, your daddy's got them Deep Ellum blues.
And then just picture like a solo here. Everybody think of your own solo. It's a thought solo. I'm fucking jamming right now. I don't know about you, but that's the fastest lead I've ever played in my head. All right, here comes the other part. They're totally fucking up. All right, who cares?
Tame Steven and his orange chode. In and out of the Kremlin they go. Country dullards, they're all wind and no brains. Wherever they go, the people all complain. Hate Steven prospered in his time. Fake news he made at our country's decline. Did it matter or does it now? Steven would answer with more bullshit and how. Woo!
More thought solos.
Wishing well in the gold-plated bell, his sagging balls hanging clear to hell. Hell halfway twixt now and then, Steven jacks off and lowers them into Trump's mouth again.
I was gonna do tiny fingers grabbing. No, never mind. When you go down to Deep Ellum to have a little fun, get your $50 ready when the policeman comes. Oh, sweet mama, daddy's got down Deep Ellum blues. Oh, sweet mama, your daddy's got down Deep Ellum blues. When you go down to Deep Ellum, put your money in your socks. The women in Deep Ellum, they put you on the rocks. Oh, sweet mama, daddy's got them Deep Ellum blues. Said, oh, sweet mama, your daddy's got them Deep Ellum blues. So when you go down to Deep Ellum, put your money in your shoes. The women in Deep Ellum got them Deep Ellum blues. Oh, sweet mama, your daddy's got them Deep Ellum blues. Said, oh, sweet mama, your daddy's got them old U.S. blues. Said, oh, sweet mama, we've all got them U.S. Blues!
Cheers, you guys!
God bless America! All right. Next up is Out of the Blue.
Good evening. Is this fun or what? So, you know, being deadheads in Maryland, we have that cool connection with the dead through the word terrapin. Right? It's a little sign language for it, if you want. Go ahead, practice. It's fun. And go Lady Terps, by the way. And you know, of course, they call them Terps because over on the Eastern Shore, terrapins are turbans. Terps, terps. Anyway, we want to start with this little song we put together. It's an ode to a little place on the Chesapeake that means a lot to us. And I'm sure you have a place just like it. But if you go over the Bay Bridge and take that first exit, this is a song about hanging out at Terrapin Park. This is from my boy, Alec. Thank you.
his turtles all the way down. Past blue heron and the persimmon tree, egrets and the crimson weed, and rose mallow in her evening gown. Yeah, rose mallow in her evening gown. bird away. Wake up to find out that you are the eyes of the world, but the heart has its beaches, its home and its parts of its own. Wake now, discover that you are the song that the morning brings, but the heart has its seasons, its evenings, its songs of its own. We'll be right back.
Singers back here joining us, everybody. Thank you very much.
I found it interesting that Jerry says this later on when he was interviewed. He says, there never was a free concert. Money is only a symbol for energy exchange. If energy exchange could be worked out with some other analog instead of money, I'd be all for it. But if it's gonna be strictly an energy ripoff trip, where the musicians get up there, sweat like hell for 3 hours, and everybody in the front row gets off, and it's all for the purpose of illustrating some philosophical point, fuck it. I thought that was pretty funny. Later on, people would say, hey man, you gotta do a concert, do it for the people. And he would say, the people? He said, have you seen how big my crew is? Have you seen how many people I employ? You know, we got families to feed, we have things to do. So his situation certainly changed after 1976 when their record company went bust and they realized that you can't really give things away for free. So, wow, this is quite an ensemble. So, next up is Matt McConville. Now, Matt is one of the founders, as well as the president of AMFM. And, so, but this is Matt's first In the Vein Of show. Can you believe that?
I had to pull some strings to get on the show. I knew a guy.
It's all right, Matt. The floor is yours, sir.
Well, thank you, Sean. Hey, let's hear it for Sean and PJ who put the show together. And all these fine musicians. God, I started playing in this town about 25 years ago. Back then, man, you could see a deadhead coming from a mile away. Now you're all incognito. Well, some of you. Night, huh, guys? Y'all having a good time? I just want everybody in this band to know that Jimi Haha's made it okay to say anything. Right? We count on Jimi for that. I got all my friends up here. I got Mr. Jimi Jacobs back here on the keyboards. I got banging Greg Benny. Playing with Benny for almost 20 years now. On the drums. Mr. Jeff Mueller over on bass. Mueller. You got Gary and Leo. Y'all know Gary and Leo here? Gary Wright and Leo Weiss?
It's a real honor to play with these guys.
And Mr. Bart Reese, we found him out in the back. He was back here like just sitting around with his band Lindsay. Come on.
All right. Let's do it.
Jam on it.
Well, we're gonna do a couple songs now. The first thing I wanna tell you is both these songs are, it's a friend talking to a friend. All right, that's the second song when we do the dead song. That's always the way I've taken it. just about not appreciating where you are, and sometimes you just need to go home.
Thank you. Just gotta have For getting us all together to do this wonderful night for the good old goddamn Grateful Dead.